Good afternoon, students. Just a couple things. As you're coming in, please find a seat on the floor. We are going to get started with our induction of scholars ceremony shortly. I'd like to draw your attention to this screen behind me. Part of today's ceremony is going to be an interactive Mentimeter that we would like you all to participate in. So instead of everybody logging in at once, if you could look behind me, on your phone, you want to go to www.menti.com. and enter the code specific to this ceremony. It is 88112, 88112. If you could pull it out and go there, if you can see it right now, we would like everybody to go log in. You will need to we would like you to participate. The Mentimeter is always more effective and fun for everybody if we're all participating at the same time. As you're coming in, just find a seat where that is overflow seating. We may need to use it, but we would really like it if you could come and join us on the floor. Appreciate that. There is a lot of seating down here, and we are going to have our ceremony beginning shortly. As well, if you're having trouble with the sign-in for menti.com, there will be a QR code up there that you can simply snap a photo of, and you can scan it and then get right to the same site. But menti.com, 88112. We'll get started shortly. Thank you. So while you're waiting, we'll draw your attention to the screens so you can see a number of interesting trivia facts out there about the University of Guelph itself and the city of Guelph specifically. We'll be right back. Just for those of you who are coming into the event center right now who may not have caught this before, I'd like to draw your attention to the screens. We do have some great facts up there if you're learning about the University of Guelph and the city of Guelph specifically. There's some great information up there for you about what a great place you are right now. For those of you just coming in, find a spot on the floor. We would ask everyone to please join us on the floor. We do have overflow seating in the bleachers, but not until the floor is filled. We do have a lot of space down here for everybody. I'll let you know a couple of things. After this, we are going to dismiss you for a lunch for everybody. So I would ask, please, that everybody stay in your seats at the conclusion of the ceremony, and then I'm going to dismiss in sections so we don't have a big bottleneck out here and everybody ends up waiting. So trust me, it'll be worth it waiting here for about 2 extra minutes with me. And then that will be in the Mitchell Gym directly out these doors for everybody, okay? Also, if we could get that Mentimeter slide up there just to show everybody again. We are going to be participating in an interactive Mentimeter today. So what we would ask you to do, so we're not all logging in at the same time, I know some people have done this already. On the screen behind me, we would ask you to please go to the website www.menti.com, and at that site it'll ask you to enter a 5-digit code. Your code is 88112. As soon as you enter that, you should see a screen that says, "What is your hometown?" Just leave it right on that screen, and we will explain what that is for later, because we would like you all to participate in that interactive Mentimeter. All right, so we have a few more people coming in. Find a seat, make a friend, and we will get started shortly. Thank you. For those of you just coming into the event center, there is lots of room at the back and on the far section as well over there. It's a little full when you come in, but there is plenty of seating on the far side of the floor. Thank you. For those of you just coming into the event center, there is seating on the far side of the event center, opposite where you're coming in, so you can just make your way around the back. Lots of seating down on the floor. We would ask everybody to join us on the floor if you can. Overflow seating in the bleachers once we are full on the floor. One last reminder to everybody who might have missed the first couple, we are going to be doing an interactive Mentimeter. So you see that QR code on your screen. You can take a photo of that and scan it. That will take you to a site. Or, as you see there, you can go to www.menti.com and enter the code 88112. We are going to ask a number of questions of you that we would like you to participate in. So please head to menti.com and enter the code for this ceremony, 88112. That'll prevent us all from signing in at the same time in just a few minutes. We will get started momentarily. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome, thank you. Welcome to your induction of scholars event here at the University of Guelph. I'm just gonna take a quick opportunity to introduce myself. My name is Sean Ferfaro. I am the voice of the Griffins here. So if you come to football, basketball, hockey, a number of sporting events, you're gonna have to listen to me. I'm the one on the mic. Also, in about 4 years, when you cross this exact same stage for convocation, I'm likely going to be the one reading your name. So, between then and now, if you've got a name that you think is going to be tough for me to pronounce, track me down. Make sure I can say it right before then. Just want to give a couple of quick announcements before we get started. Emergency exits, in case the unlikely event of having to evacuate the event center here, I want you to just identify your nearest exit. So you see that green running man symbol behind me? All of our exits are marked by the running man symbol. So if we have to evacuate, in the back over there, there is a door. There is a staircase that will take you upstairs and out. Over here, there is a door that can take you to the front entrance and out, or you can go over here. So you see those three running man symbols. If there's a fire or something and we need to evacuate, under no circumstances, run that way. There's no way out. So one of those three exits if you need, and you can head out through the Larry Pearson lobby on the lower level. One last thing before we get started. I mentioned this already. At the end of this event, there is a free lunch for you. There is a process to that so that we all don't go over to the lunch at the same time. It's going to be over in the Mitchell Gym, which is just over out through these doors and straight through. We are going to dismiss section by section. So there are four sections here. So please, at the end of the ceremony, we can't have you all jumping up. You're just going to all wait in line in a bottleneck in the hallway. So wait here for a couple extra minutes with me, and I'll get you over to your lunch as soon as possible. All right? With that, welcome to your Induction of Scholars event here at the University of Guelph, and it is my pleasure to introduce our Vice Provost of Student Affairs, Dr. Carrie Chassels.
Thank you, Sean, and good afternoon, Griffins. As your Vice Provost, it's important for you to know that I am your number one fan and your staunchest advocate. The student affairs professionals, you've met many of them already. They've been helping you in student housing. They've been helping you in terms of your O-Week activities. That's just part of our student affairs portfolio. And as your Vice Provost, just remember, number one fan, staunchest advocate. Welcome to your induction of scholars. As you've heard throughout O-Week, at the University of Guelph, it's our privilege to acknowledge that the university resides on the ancestral lands of the Attawandaron people and the unceded territory and treaty lands of the Mississaugas of the Credit. With our commitment to improve life, we embrace our First Peoples Dish with One Spoon covenant that reminds us of our shared responsibility to take good care of our local and global communities, to understand that we as a people are interconnected to each other and to the land, air, water that sustain all living things. Today, our communities are home to many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit Indigenous peoples, including our Anishinaabe and Haudenosaunee neighbors. Acknowledging and respecting them reminds us of our important connection to each other and to this land where we live, love, work, learn, and play. We've been keeping you pretty busy settling in to our community and your new home as Griffins. We hope that we've been successful in helping you feel at home and welcome, and we're excited to see where your U of G experience takes you. You may notice a change in tone today as our deans, chairs, faculty, and staff come together to intentionally shift your focus to your academic journey in a more formal setting. We do this with some of the pomp and ceremony of a convocation ceremony to signal that it's our intention to support you in that academic journey, and in a few years, we look forward to wearing our academic robes once again to celebrate your graduation. During O Week, we've been getting to know each other, but there are a few things that we'd like to know today. To help us get to know each other, if you haven't already, please log into menti.com and use the code listed on the screen, 88112. And once you're logged in, so those of you who've already logged in, this is our first Mentimeter question. We want to know, what is your hometown? We have Griffins who have lived in this community for all their lives, and we have Griffins who are new to Guelph, coming from other parts of Ontario and Canada, but some coming from more than 60 countries around the world. Guelph has a lot to offer on and off campus. Explore together and find ways to get involved. Over the past few days, you've been learning what it means to be a Griffin. You've been learning about what makes our alumni among the strongest and proudest in Canada. But do you know what a Griffin is? A Griffin is a proud, mythical creature with a head, talons, and wings of an eagle and the body of a lion. When you arrived on campus this weekend, you might have seen the Griffin statue at the corner of Gordon and Stone, where it sits on a book to protect knowledge and our Griffin family. Rubbing the beak of the Griffin and committing to a successful academic year has become part of our U of G student traditions, along with painting the cannon and dressing the begging bear. If you haven't already, today might be a good day to rub the Griffin's beak and take a picture to capture the moment. Although we still have a lot of fun to have at tonight's pep rally, today is really about shifting your focus to academics, which leads me to my next question. On Menti, which college are you part of? It can be complicated knowing the difference between your college degree program and your major, but today is your opportunity to learn these important details. You need to know about your academic programs. You'll learn more, if you haven't already, at the meeting for majors and at the resource fair in Brannion Plaza. There will be a lot of information for you to take in today. The most important thing is for you to leave today knowing where you can go to find the information when you need it. Let's see what academic support is already on your radar. For your next question, if you need academic advice, where will you go? Option one, figure it out yourself. Option two, ask a friend. Option three, ask an academic advisor. The best advice is don't guess. You can start with your friends, but then always make sure that you confirm by checking in with an academic program advisor. Faculty are also a great source of information specific to their course and for directing you to the right resources to answer your questions. You might also have questions regarding your career goals, experiential learning opportunities, and part-time employment on and off campus. The advisors in the Experiential Learning Hub will be happy to help you think about your strengths and career pathways. Your career goals may change as you are introduced to new areas of study at U of G, but based on where you're at today, what are your career goals? We're just waiting for the mentee to flip over to career goals. No more mentees? Oh, well then, think about what your career goal is. There's a real reason why I ask you that question, and it's because research tells us that students who start their post-secondary journey with a goal in mind, even if that goal changes, but just having a goal in mind leads significantly to your ultimate success upon graduation and beyond. You are well on your way. You chose the University of Guelph, and we are really proud that you did. You are a Griffin, and you've been learning that Griffins are respectful, caring, determined, engaged, and authentic. You are and will be a Griffin for life. If you talk to any Griffin alumni, they will agree with that. At tonight's pep rally, it's our one time when we all get together to celebrate as Griffins. At the pep rally, almost 5,000 Griffins are going to come together at the stadium to let on their boogie and cheer loud. And you're going to see me there tonight dressed a little bit differently. I won't be wearing my academic robes. I'll be in my fan gear. But I want to practice getting the crowd pumped up, because this is what I do. I'll have my cowbell. I'm going to leave my drum and siren at home. But I want to practice right now. When you hear me tonight say, "Who are we?" what do I want you to shout? Griffins! All right, so let's practice. Who are we? Ooh. All right, that is not going to work. Who are we? Okay. If I am louder than you, there's a problem. Who are we? One more time. You better be better tonight, I'm telling you. All right. We are proud to have you in the Griffin family. We're really happy that you joined us to help us all improve life.
At the University of Guelph, we're united by one common mission: to improve life. Life is full of fun and interesting challenges, and the status quo is no longer enough. We need to collaborate, continue to evolve, and improve. Everything we teach here focuses on the whole person to shape better citizens of the world. Are you ready? Ready to engage your community? Learn better ways to nourish all living creatures. Learn ethical, sustainable business practices. Integrate culture into all fields of study. Learn solutions that safely connect humankind to this planet and beyond. Celebrate diversity and inclusivity. To improve life is our shared challenge. What role will you play? Let's find out.
Students, once again, my name is Sean Ferfaro. I'm the voice of the Griffins. I would like to officially now welcome you to the Induction of Scholars ceremony this morning. The traditions of academia have evolved over a millennium. The gowns, the hats, and the hoods are symbols that represent that history. The University of Guelph crest, which you will see on the screen behind me momentarily, represents our specific history here at Guelph. The emblems in the crest show links with the royal city of Guelph through the White Stallion, the connection through to the liberal arts through the book, the sciences through the astrolab, and our connection to abundance and agriculture through the cornucopia. The university motto, Rerum cognoscere causas, is a quote from Virgil. It's variously translated to be either happy is the one who is able to ascertain the reason of things, or perhaps to know the meaning of things. The procession of people into the hall is also influenced by ancient tradition. The piper will herald the start of the procession. This will be followed by the arrival of the mace leading the platform party. The mace is a ceremonial staff, which is a symbol of the authority of the university. It will be carried by the beadle, who today is the ceremonial officer of Senate. Following the beadle and mace will be the president, members of the administration, board, senate, deans, members of faculty and staff, as well as student leaders. You will be asked to stand as the procession enters the room and remain standing for the national anthem. President Vaccarino will open the ceremony with a formal, then Associate Vice President Academic Dr. Kate Dewey will present you all to be inducted into your various programs. A similar process to what you will experience as you all graduate from your various programs. Finally, you will hear from the President of the Alumni Association, Richard Horn. Your relationship with the University of Guelph doesn't end when you graduate. You will then become alumni. Today is your first step in that journey. Once a Griffin, always a Griffin. Students, welcome to your induction at the University of Guelph. Please stand as you're able as the academic procession makes its way to the stage. Please remain standing for our national anthem.
Please be seated. Well, let me take this opportunity to welcome everyone to the induction of scholars at the University of Guelph. And I know you've been having probably a good time the last few days, and the fun will continue this week during O-Week and as well as your move-in time. And today really is about your academic life here. So I do want to take this opportunity to welcome all of you. My name is Franco Vaccarino, and I have the honor and the great privilege of serving as the President and Vice Chancellor of the University of Guelph. And welcome again, scholars, to the University of Guelph. You have joined, as you know, a post-secondary institution that ranks among the very, very top comprehensive research-intensive universities in Canada. You are also part of a long tradition of innovation and excellence here at the university that actually dates back more than 150 years to our founding colleges. And I don't know how many of you have our history fresh in your mind, but our history goes back to the three founding colleges, the Ontario Agricultural College, Ontario Veterinary College, and McDonald Institute. And the OAC, the Ontario Agricultural College, goes back, as I said, more than close to 150 years. And in a sense, what it's a reminder of is that what I think is a very special sense of ourselves, where on the one hand we have this deep-rooted, long-standing tradition, and on the other hand we have a very powerful, new and emerging sense of ourselves moving forward. Guelph became a comprehensive, full-fledged university in 1964. In fact, we recently celebrated our 50th year as a comprehensive university. So you can take pride that you've joined not only a university with a long-standing history steeped in pride, but also a forward-looking community of researchers, of scholars, and learners that are really making a difference for ourselves today and for tomorrow. Now, over the next few years, you will be challenged and you will be inspired. You'll be challenged and inspired to learn more about your chosen discipline. I would suggest that you will also learn and be inspired and learn more about yourselves and the wider world around you. I think the process of learning, the process of what you will go through, will tell you a lot about yourselves, how you overcome challenges, how you encounter opportunities, new friends, new contexts. And it'll be as much about learning about yourself as it will about learning about the broader world around you. The University of Guelph is also a very inclusive community that celebrates diversity, equity, and inclusion. And I say that for many, many reasons that are important to us. But one of them is the fact that we very much believe in the power of multiple perspectives, looking at problems, complex problems, and there's so many subtle and nuanced complex problems in our world today, and to ensure that we have a broad sense of perspective around the challenges and issues that our world faces today. And diversity and inclusion is such an important part of creating those diverse perspectives and creating that broader understanding. We also pride ourselves on our strong relations with the wider community. Guelph is ranked among the very best places to live in Canada, and the University of Guelph, you should know, is a key part of what makes this community unique. And I really encourage all of you to take advantage of our connection, not just on campus, but our connection with the broader community. It's a terrific city, the downtown area, the broader surroundings of Guelph. So again, take advantage of both the on and off campus opportunities to make a difference, and to make a difference fundamentally to improve life. And that's our tagline at the university, and in many ways captures our mission. It's actually quite simple, improve life, two words, but really I think actually quite profound, because it kind of challenges all of us as individuals, say, well, how is my experience here going to improve life? How will I do my part to make things better? And on that note, it's my absolute pleasure to introduce to you Dr. Kate Dewey, who is the Associate Vice President of Academic here at the University, and invite her to bring greetings to the group. Kate's somewhere behind me. Dr. Dewey.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. It is indeed a great opportunity to celebrate both our history and, of course, you and our future at the University of Guelph. I'm really pleased to be here today to welcome you to the beginning of your University of Guelph journey. This isn't part of my notes, but I'll just tell you that I came here when I was your age, and I did leave for a little while, but I'm excited for you because I remember what that feels like. So I'd like you to look around you. You're surrounded by hundreds of your peers, all beginning the same journey you're on. And this makes the university journey a truly unique experience in your lifetime, with this many people starting together. All of you share a common experience. You're seeking an education here at the University of Guelph. You're likely anxious about first experiences, but know that this is shared by everyone here. Know that as you go to your first lecture and feel a flutter in your stomach, wondering if you will know anyone, do you look okay? Will you succeed? These are feelings that are shared by all of you. Jump in and embrace your university experience. Have fun. This is a significant part of your entire life's journey, this university experience. Over the next weeks and months, you will explore new ideas, new theorems, new problems, and find new friends. By the time you've reached the end of this year, and in the 4 or 5 years to come, you will have friendships that will last the rest of your life. These years begin the process for preparing you for the next stage of your life. Don't rush to the end point. It's not just getting to the end of an exam or finishing a paper. It's the process of learning, reading, figuring out the math problem, sorting out the lab. Learning is your experience of growing and gaining knowledge. If something's difficult, ask for help. You're not here alone. Find the resources that will help you, maybe in the library. Talk to your professor. Find a teaching assistant to discuss that with, or perhaps a technician. And make sure you reach out to your peers. Embrace this important process of learning and know that you can succeed. On stage with me today are members of the senior administration, college deans, faculty, staff, and student leaders. We're all here today to celebrate your induction into the university. Someday, we will make a lot of your graduation in this very same room. But today is also a day to celebrate. It's your first day, your starting point, and this is the beginning of your academic career. And it's incredibly important. We applaud you because you've achieved an enormous level of success just to be here today. So feel good about yourself. We applaud your courage to come to university, to experience new things and take those extra risks. Embrace the University of Guelph and its environment that allows you to pursue your dreams and your passions on this campus. This is the beginning of you changing your world and the world around you. Welcome, and all the best to you in your undergraduate degree. I would like all entering students to please stand. President Vaccarino, by virtue of the authority vested in, my mistake, it's always good to make a mistake. Makes people laugh sometimes. Mr. Vice Chancellor, that's better. I have the honor to present to you these scholars who have enrolled in the University of Guelph and ask that they may be admitted to their various and several undergrad programs.
By virtue of the authority vested in me and in the University of Guelph, I hereby admit all of you to the University of Guelph.
You may now be seated. And now it's my pleasure to invite to the podium Courtney DeCare, Vice President of the University of Guelph Alumni Association.
Good afternoon and welcome, scholars. My name is Courtney DeCare, and I'm the Vice President of the University of Guelph Alumni Association. Today is your special day. You have officially been inducted into a community of academics who are committed to an important and compelling mandate, to improve life. On behalf of the University of Guelph Alumni Association and the thousands of U of G alumni who have walked this path before you, I want to congratulate you on this milestone. You'll notice a small gift on each of your seats from the Alumni Association. It's our hope that you'll place this on the back of your phone so that you'll be reminded throughout your time at Guelph that one day you'll all be graduates of this amazing institution. I hope this ceremony gives you a taste of what's to come. In 4 years, you'll be back in this very room, crossing this same stage to receive the degrees you worked so hard to complete. At Convocation, your academic career in Guelph will have come full circle. As you proudly shake the university president's hand, just know that your alumni family is waiting to welcome you to your next journey with the University of Guelph. Convocation may feel like a distant dream today, but I promise you it will be here before you know it. So enjoy your time at Guelph. Paint the cannon, relax with friends at the bullring, wind your toy, study hard, and make your dreams a reality. I'm so excited to witness the ideas, research, innovation, teaching, and learning that each of you will contribute to the University of Guelph's academic landscape. Always remember that the alumni community is cheering you on. Thank you and welcome, Griffins.
Well, thank you very much, Courtney, for those remarks. And let me again take this opportunity to congratulate all of you and to welcome all of you to the university. One of the expressions I like to use is beginnings are important. And really what I mean by that is how things start are important because they set you on a certain trajectory. And I have to say that there's a great buzz, I think, to this group, and I've had the opportunity to meet quite a few of the students over the last few days, and there's a real nice positive energy. Actually, we have two of our international students there, one's from the Punjab and from Turkey here, so welcome. We were just chatting on the way up, and again, it was representative of that very positive energy that I sense here with the students. So beginnings are important. I'm sensing a really good beginning, and isn't it a nice coincidence that we even have the Raptors winning the NBA final this year. So it's a good year to start at the university. Yes. So on that note, again, welcome, congratulations. Enjoy the rest of the week. I think I'll be seeing you again this evening for a few minutes. I'll be there at the pep rally. And I'm reminded of the first year when I started here, I had never really spoken at a pep rally. And I have to say, when it's the first time and you're the old guy up on the stage and there's a pep rally, it was quite an experience. So anyways, we're going to see you this evening, but welcome all of you. Enjoy your time here. Have a fantastic year. And I'm just going to repeat something that Dr. Dewey mentioned. We have all sorts of supports here for you. Take advantage of them. You know, there's going to be highs. There's going to be challenges during the year. Don't be shy. Reach out. We have great mentors. We have programs here, advisors, academic advising, career advising. And just if you need to talk to people, we have all sorts of opportunities for that to support you. And on that note, again, all the very, very best and good wishes for the coming year. Thank you.